What transformations does one undergo on the path
No transformation. The consciousness is there. It is now filled with all rubbish things. You have to clean this and then to some consciousness. Just like water. Water is by nature clear, transparent. But when it is filled up with rubbish things, it is muddy. You cannot see very clearly. But if you filter it, all muddy things, dirty things, then again it comes to the original position. Clear, transparent.
Does one function better in society as a result of affiliation with Krishna consciousness?
Does one function in society better after being Krishna conscious?
What do you mean? Is he a better citizen? Is he a better citizen?
And also sociologically or can he work better in the community?
That you can see that. They are not drunkards. They are not meeting from a physiological point of view, they are very clean. They are never attacked to you. So, how many diseases? Then they do not eat meat. Meat is the most sinful, to kill others for the satisfaction of the tongue. God has given to the human society so many things to eat, nice fruits, nice flowers, nice grains, first class meat, and from meat you can do bread and live now. You deserve food. But they do not know the art. They are maintaining big, big slaughterhouse and eating meat. No distinction. That means they are not even civilized. When man is not civilized, he kills one animal anyway. Because he does not know how to grow food. Just like we have got one farm, land, room now. So we are preparing so first class preparation from milk. They never ask, they come, they are astonished. But from being such nice person, hundreds. So that means they are not even civilized. How to prepare nutritious food from milk? Milk, accepting that cow flesh and blood is very nutritious. That we also admit. But the civilized man utilizes the blood and meat in a different way. The meat is nothing but blood. But it is transformed into meat. And again from meat you make so many things, making bird, car, you make ghee, so many things. And combination of this twin product with grains, with fruits and vegetables, similar hundreds of people. So this is civilized. Not that directly kill one animal and eat. That is uncivilized. You take the accepting that cow's flesh and blood is very nutritious. Take it in a civilized way. Why you should kill it? The innocent animal is simply eating grass given by God and supplying milk. And from milk it can be. And the gratefulness is that what is called? Is that civilization? What do you say?
Is that civilization?
No, I agree with you 100%. I want you to say these things, though, instead of me. I'm asking you questions so that hopefully that not by me describing anything, just a short question.
These things are uncivilized way of life, and what they will understand God.
I'm asking these questions for everyone that feel that's in that is not understanding.
To understand God means one must be first class civilized. Just like university is meant for first class students. Similarly, God consciousness means meant for the first class human.
Okay, this question is a hard one for me to ask because it shows ignorance on my part, but I'm not asking it in ignorance. I want your answer on tape, okay? Does all desire ultimately have to go, including the desire to attain Krishna consciousness?
Without Krishna consciousness, we will absolutely ravish desire. And when you are Krishna consciousness, when you desire, right?
The aim of many spiritual paths is to find the guru within.
Within?
The guru within. Is this different than...
He said that to find the guru within.
Kirpal Singh.
Pardon me?
Kirpal Singh. He's one of
them. Krishna. I know there are.
Krishna. Hmm? Krishnamurti.
So why does he come to teach? These things are spoken by Raskal. He has come to teach. And he says, find out the guru within. So why you have come to me? Because people are not intelligent. They cannot catch it. He talks on nonsense and they hear.
He also has written a book about no books are needed.
You can find out how that's going. Is it not? He admits on that. He writes book and he says there is no need of books. He has
right,
come
yeah.
to teach and he says there is no need of teacher is needed. Is he not a rascal?
Well, they say those people...
First of all, he answers my question.
Oh.
He says contradictory things. Is he not a rascal?
Well, he's contradicting himself.
Therefore, he's a rascal.
Can the Vedas be taken symbolically as well as literally?
As it is. We are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is, not symbolically.